Hello, Wellness Warriors. Welcome back to the Entheogen Explorer channel. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the elusive and mysterious vitamin B8 that nobody talks about, also known as inositol. I'm going to be teaching you about all the reasons why you probably want to be taking inositol as part of your supplement regimen. Stick around to the end to find out exactly how much and when to take inositol for best results. The benefits of inositol have a wide range of applications. It's been studied for a variety of conditions such as PCOS or polycystic ovarian syndrome, as well as depression, anxiety, panic attacks, metabolic diseases, and sleep disturbances. Low levels of inositol are associated with conditions such as depression and anorexia, and inositol is considered a B vitamin, though it's lesser known, and it's not an essential nutrient because your body can actually make inositol from glucose. But don't let that fool you into thinking that this vitamin does not pack a powerful punch. Say that three times fast. Pack a powerful punch, pack a powerful punch, pack a powerful punch. Inositol is a naturally occurring sugar found in the body and is made from glucose and is responsible for a number of different processes, including insulin regulation, neurotransmitter synthesis, epigenetic regulation, cytoskeleton formation, calcium signaling, and fat metabolism. There are a number of different forms of inositol, and many are found in foods such as cantaloupe, grains, beans, legumes, and nuts. The most common form of inositol found in the human body and in supplements is myo-inositol. There are also D-chiro-inositol forms of supplements, and some of these supplements combine myo-inositol and D-chiro forms in specific ratios. Now that you know a little bit about what inositol or vitamin B8 actually is, why don't I tell you about some of the inositol benefits? There's been a number of clinical trials exploring inositol and PCOS, depression, anxiety, insulin resistance, metabolic diseases, inflammation, infertility, acne, panic attacks, eating disorders, OCD, and more. Inositol has been found to increase sensitivity to insulin while reducing insulin resistance in those with metabolic issues. Because increased insulin is associated with poor ovarian function, by normalizing insulin levels and improving ovarian function, many women with PCOS or polycystic ovarian syndrome are finding tremendous relief using inositol. Inositol is so good at improving ovarian and oocyte egg health that even healthy women benefit from it. Inositol has actually revolutionized women's healthcare and reproductivity management in the modern medical care system because it's so effective. And inositol has also been found to increase fertility in not only women, but men as well by increasing their sperm count. So if you're trying to make some babies, maybe skip the wine and try sharing some inositol with your lover. Nothing says romance like regulating insulin. Because inositol is so good at reducing insulin levels by improving insulin sensitivity, it's so good for a number of metabolic and insulin-related disorders such as diabetes, cancer, autoimmune conditions, acne, neurodegenerative diseases, ovarian problems, and more. Inositol has been found to reduce the symptoms of depression. It acts as a secondary messenger molecule, interacting with serotonin and other neurotransmitters. It has been found to increase serotonin receptor sensitivity and exhibits SSRI-like activity. Some studies have compared inositol to antidepressants such as Prozac and found that it delivered equally good results. One risk of antidepressant medications is a condition called serotonin syndrome. Serotonin syndrome happens when you have too much serotonin in the brain and can actually lead to damage or even death. Administration of inositol has been found to reduce and mitigate the effects of serotonin syndrome in a neuroprotective way. Inositol has been studied, compared against a number of different antidepressant drugs, and found to be just as effective, if not more effective, than conventional antidepressants. Inositol increases the density of serotonin and dopamine receptors, improving mood, cognition, and neuroregulation. Also, by lowering insulin levels, inositol allows entering of amino acid molecules into the cell where they can become neurotransmitter molecules such as serotonin, dopamine, GABA, and glutamate. Inositol has been studied for OCD, anxiety, and panic attacks, as well as being comparatively effective to an SSRI for treating bulimia. Inositol displays a number of anti-inflammatory effects, which could explain the benefits on mood, brain, and hormone health. Inositol reduces LDL cholesterol, blood glucose levels, and a number of inflammatory biomarkers, such as C-reactive protein, TNF-alpha, IL-6, and other inflammatory cytokines. Inositol has been found to reduce neuropathic pain and improve nerve health. Inositol is super helpful for promoting quality sleep. It makes falling asleep really easy, but doesn't sedate you and make you feel groggy like other supplements or drugs might. There are very few reported inositol side effects. As far as I know, nobody that I've ever talked to has had any real side effects from inositol. Though I suppose if you take a lot, it's possible to feel a little bit too relaxed and perhaps sleepy. I've personally never really experienced that, and I've never heard of anyone experiencing GI distress, anxiety, or insomnia as a result of taking inositol. For me, inositol has actually become one of my favorite supplements lately. I started taking it and I noticed dramatic improvement in my mood, my sleep quality, my ability to focus, and also my hormones. I used to get a lot of hormonal issues that would manifest as depression, especially right before my cycle. And since I've started taking the inositol, it has pretty much gone away, as long as I'm still taking the inositol. Which is totally worth it, even if that's the only benefit that I've gotten. But it has also helped me sort of regulate the speed and the energy consumption of my brain. I would say that I have something called glutamate excitotoxicity, which I talk about in another video of mine that you should check out. But basically, my brain kind of moves unsustainably fast, and there's a lot of power coursing through it, but in a somewhat chaotic, disorganized way, and I sort of feel like I blow my load, energetically speaking, by having like too much fast brain activity in the earlier part of the day, and then absolutely crashing by the afternoon and being wiped out and not able to do anything. My brain is a bit like powerful yet clumsy, kind of like a baby dinosaur. So have all this like raw power pushing through it, but in a way that's sort of chaotic and unsustainable. The inositol, I feel like, kind of dampens and puts like a weighted blanket almost on my brain so that it can have sustained paced energy throughout the day that allows me to stay focused, to stay clear, to stay happy throughout the entire day instead of just like, and then crashing. So that's been the biggest thing I've noticed. And it's also helped tremendously with my food cravings and kind of impulsive eating. I don't really get a lot of satiety signals from when I eat because of some weird insulin resistance that I have developed. And I found that when I'm taking inositol regularly, I have way more control over my impulsive eating behaviors, my food cravings, and also just how much food that I'm consuming. I can't even stress how awesome inositol has been adding it to my health regime and my daily life. It's one of those supplements that I am so grateful that I found, and I think you should probably try it out too. Here's a recap on why you should probably take inositol. Inositol has an incredible safety profile, has virtually no side effects, and tremendous benefits. It's affordable, accessible, easy to take, and can be taken in conjunction with antidepressant and anti-anxiety medications. Inositol is so easy to take. It tastes sweet and is water soluble. So you can either just put it straight in your mouth, like I like to do, or you can put it in water and dissolve it and take it that way. Some people like to take capsules, but I don't understand why you would need to do that because it tastes so good. If you have stress, anxiety, PCOS, metabolic issues, trouble focusing, or are dealing with sugar cravings, you should probably give inositol a try. I recommend the Myo-inositol form of inositol because it's inexpensive, easy to get, and it performs great in the clinical research on it. The D-chiro-inositol version is much pricier, and so I think the Myo-inositol form is perfectly suitable for most people. Now, many people recommend the IP6 version of inositol, which is also called phytic acid. I don't particularly recommend this form because phytic acid is actually a lectin molecule that is on seeds and nuts, specifically almonds, and it's there to actually protect the nut from being eaten by animals. And so while there is research on this molecule's ability to disrupt cancer cells, it also acts as an anti-nutrient binding agent, which means it binds to essential nutrients and minerals such as iron and zinc. And so for me, unless cancer is a specific concern of yours or you're experiencing cancer, I personally believe that the anti-nutrient binding properties of IP6 or phytic acid are actually a net negative compared to the benefits that you have for cancer prevention. This is just how I feel about it, and my opinion might change in the future as I learn more about it. The appropriate inositol dosage, as always, depends on the goals and the needs of the individual. Most people I would recommend to take 1 to 3 grams per day, spaced out throughout the day in 2 or 3 doses. However, some of the clinical trials, for example, in patients with depression, people are taking up to 12 grams per day or 4 grams per day for those with PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome, and even up to 14 grams per day for those with OCD. If you're inspired to try inositol, there's a link in the description with my recommendation of the product brand that I like to use. Now, it is an affiliate link, so I do get a kickback if you choose to buy it at no extra cost to you. This video gave you a nice dopamine hit. Be sure to subscribe at the button below so that every week on Monday at 6 p.m. PST, you can get another dopamine hit when you see that I've released another video for your enjoyment.